The drone work is really, really important in terms of preserving cultural heritage because it offers a really rich document that can be created in just a matter of days. And so the model of Palmyra that you see behind me was created relatively quickly, a couple of weeks of drone work. And that's something that's much, much quicker than traditional archaeological campaigns. And you get a really accurate, up-to-the-minute document of the state of preservation or destruction of a particular site. This site is Palmyra, which is a site in Syria that was destroyed largely by ISIS in 2016, and aerial drone work has allowed for the reconstruction of this site in the digital realm. And so that's really important because it explains how digital technology and drones can be used in heritage preservation going forward. It's really just been within the last 10 years that archaeologists have begun to capitalize on the potential of using drones in their work. Archaeological documentation up until now has really been a two-dimensional enterprise. There's a lot of line drawings, a lot of measurements, and so although it's necessary to sort of understand the third dimension in order to interpret the past, there really hasn't been a technological way to do that effectively and efficiently in a sort of a low-cost way until drones came in the picture. And so drones really, what they do is they summarize a lot of different kinds of data about a site thing, and then they bring it all together. And so instead of sort of separating it out and siloing that data in multiple different data sets, they make it really intelligible so that archaeologists can get to the work of actually interpreting the remains quicker. There's been drone work everywhere from Machu Picchu to the Middle East, Europe. Largely drone work is concentrated on some of the better known sites. Those have been kind of the first sites to receive attention and support for this type of projects. But we are trying to focus as well on some of the less famous sites locally here in Florida as well as globally. So I think that in the next 10 years, archaeological applications of drone work are really going to emphasize non-monumental sites in a way that work up until now hasn't really done. So I think you're going to see a lot of sites that aren't necessarily famous, but they're important scientifically, and also to sort of increase public access and understanding to a wide range of sites.